question this week from an organization that wanted to contract us to grant write for them. And as a start of the conversation with the organization, I asked them, you're wanting someone that's going to grant write, grant research, manage reports, do all this stuff. I said, why aren't you looking at hiring an employee? Because they actually write a lot of grants every year. And as we started to talk, I realized maybe they didn't have a strategic plan, because if you look at a strategic plan and it is part of your plan to grow your grant program, to grow the number of foundations, governmental entities that you are requesting dollars from, then it makes sense maybe to hire a full-time grant writer. Or if you're an organization that just manages a ton of grants, like I've worked with the Cherokee in North Carolina before, and they manage about 200 grants a year, right? That's every year. So they need a department for grants. Other organizations I've worked with, maybe the executive director or the development director are writing a majority of the grants. Maybe they put in 10 or 15 applications a year. Don't really need a full-time staff designated specifically for that. So as we had this conversation, I asked a couple of key questions that I thought might be helpful for you if you're in the position of deciding, should we hire, should we contract, should we do this in-house? And here's a couple of key takeaways for you. One, I always encourage people to learn the skill set in-house, whether you're going to contract out or not. Because if you're going to contract someone out and you don't know the skill set, how are you going to manage them? How are you going to know what they should be doing? How are you going to know what they're talking about when they tell you what they have done? Or are you going to be able to recognize when they maybe have skipped steps or not done things the way that you would have done them, right? So even if you're going to contract out, make sure you know the skill set yourself, even if it's going and taking a grant writing workshop just to get some of the highlights. Two, if you can write in-house, I recommend that, because it's not feasible to continuously contract someone out for a service for the foreseeable future of your organization, especially if you're planning on being around for a while, which hopefully you are, or you wouldn't have started your organization. The other thing is it cheaper for you to hire someone or to contract? And part of that's going to be, what's the going rate in your area by the hour? Can you get someone that's willing to do the research, the writing, the reporting, and everything else you need? We talked about the reporting a little bit. I mentioned to this particular organization, I said, we don't typically do reporting for organizations. I say typically, we never do reporting for organizations. The reason why is when you are working at an organization, you're in the program, you're involved in the project, you're the staff person. So you're the one tracking the information that's going to be needed for the reporting. You're the one that should have the rapport and the relationship with the foundation. We're just the grant writers. We're the ones who write it, put it together, help you make sure it's a quality proposal, help you create the templates. You submit it. And my name is never on that application. So you need to be the one building that relationship, and therefore you're the one that needs to submit those final reports. It's a lot of management for an outside organization to work with staff to make sure reporting requirements are met throughout the year and that data is being tracked. So there's just a couple of things to think about as you try to decide if you're going to contract someone or keep it in-house or hire someone full-time to help you with your grant writing needs. If you have additional questions, please feel free to email us, mandy@fundingforgood.org, message us in the box below, or shoot us a message on Facebook. We look forward to talking to you soon.